Well, hello one and all, and welcome to our short on lists. Now we'll be exploring how we can store information in certain orders within Python. And I have here a game called Super Mario Kart, which if you're not familiar is a racing game for the Nintendo Entertainment System way back in the, the 90s or so. And the idea is you would play as Mario, Luigi, Princess Peach, and race to get a certain place in the race, whether it was first, second, third, first, or fourth, whatever it was. We're going to make a list here to represent the racers and their place when they cross the finish line here. So I'll come to my terminal here, and I'll go ahead and code results.py. And to make a list in Python, well, I can think about how I want to store these racers. Maybe Mario came first, followed by Luigi. So Mario in first place, Luigi in second place. I could make a list in Python by first giving it some kind of name. So here, I'll give this list the name results, just like this, results. And I'll say results equals, in this case, well, a list. And a list in Python is denoted by these brackets here, these square brackets, opening and closing. Now within these two brackets, I can actually place this information in the order I want it to be. So first, I could place Mario, saying Mario came first in this particular race, followed by, in this case, Luigi, just like this. And notice how each of these elements is separated by a comma. So Mario came first, followed by Luigi. So here, I've created a list just explicitly on my own. I made a list, add the elements, and so on. But often in Python, you might have a list you want to dynamically add to as your program runs. Here I've initialized a list, but how could I keep adding more racers in this case? Well, let's say after Mario and Luigi comes Princess Peach. So I could, if I wanted to add on to this list, use a method called append. Append adds a new element to the end of this list here. So I could try results.append. I take my name of my list, use dot and then append to add on some new element at the end of this list. And back in the Super Nintendo Entertainment System era, Princess Peach was actually just called Princess. So I'll use that name here. And I'll add the princess to our list here, saying that she came in third. Now let's see where we're going here. So if I were to print the results, I can use print here and just call print results. I can then run Python of results.py, and down below, I'll see Mario, Luigi, and Princess. So Mario in first place, Luigi in second place, and Princess in third place so far. Well, maybe as the race goes on, we have more racers who finish, so I could keep appending if I wanted to. I could say results.append, and maybe after Princess comes, let's say, Yoshi, another player you can play in this game. After Yoshi comes Koopa Troopa, and then after Koopa Troopa comes, let's say, Toad. So these are our results. I'll go ahead and run Python results.py, and now we'll see our results for the first six finishers. Again, Mario in first place, Luigi in second, Princess in third, and the rest following thereafter. Now, we could, if we wanted to, try to add more than one racer at a time. Maybe we get the results for Bowser and Donkey Kong Jr. at a pretty similar time, so we could try to add both of them at once to our list. One way to do this would be as follows. I could go ahead and say results.append and add on maybe a list to my list. I could try adding on, in this case, Bowser, followed by Donkey Kong Jr. And hopefully what we'll see is that these two elements, these two racers, Bowser and Donkey Kong, get added at the end of our list all at once. But let's see. If I were to run Python of results.py, what we'll see here, that we still have our first six or so finishers. But then at the end, I'm noticing that Bowser and Donkey Kong Jr., well, they're added into our list, but they seem to be inside of a list themselves. Notice the curly brackets around their names there. So how could we fix this? Well, if we want to add onto our list using a list itself, we can't use append. Append actually goes ahead and adds the list itself to our list. So why don't I go ahead and remove this? I'll say results.remove, which is another method I can use to remove items, and I can give as input to remove the list itself. And why don't we do this instead? I'll say results.extend, and I can give extend now a list, but it will really take each element of that list and append it to, in this case, my original list called results. So to be clear, we're starting now with a list of two racers who finished, Mario and Luigi. We're adding in Princess, Yoshi, Koopa Troopa, and Toad each individually. We tried to add the list of Bowser and Donkey Kong Jr., but we realized we can't use append for that, so we removed them instead. And now we'll try extending our list, which will take each of Bowser and Donkey Kong Jr. and add them individually to our results list here. So let's try this. I'll run Python of results.py, and hopefully I'll see down below that we can in fact see all 8 now of our finishers, each on our list, with no sublists, if you will, inside of our one larger list. So here is an example of our list and how we've added racers to it. What more can we do with lists? Well, let's go ahead and try to maybe take our list as it exists down here. I can really just copy and paste this. Actually, let me not copy paste. I'll come back up here and I will do results equals, and I'll type in Mario, Luigi, oh, Princess, Yoshi, Koopa Troopa, Toad, Bowser, and Donkey Kong Jr. So a bit of a long list we have up here, but this will enable us to see a few more features of lists as well. So one other one we could want to be familiar with is just getting a sense for what remove might actually do here. So here I have a list where Bowser is clearly part of this list. Bowser, it looks like, is in 7th place in this race. But I could remove Bowser entirely. I could say results.remove and then give as input Bowser. And this remove method will actually search through my list and find the first instance of Bowser and remove that element as well. So I'll run Python of results.py and we'll see down below that Bowser is no longer in our race. But let's say Bowser tries to cheat the system a little bit and we remove Bowser, but we later go on and try to add Bowser back in. Well, we saw with results.append, if I were to append Bowser, Bowser would show up at the end of our list, in this case in 8th place, but we don't really want that for Bowser. Bowser would, of course, prefer to be in 1st place. So I could try this. I could try a new method, one called insert. And insert takes as its first argument the index at which I want to insert some given element. So recall how our lists are actually indexed from 0. 0 is the first element, 1 is the second element, and so on and so forth. So for instance, Mario here is at the 0th index, Luigi at the first index, Princess at the second index. So if I wanted Bowser to kind of sneakily move up to first place, I could try to insert Bowser, of course, at the 0th index, and say, as the second argument, the actual element I want to introduce, so Bowser in this case. So what have we done? We've had our list of results up here with Bowser in 7th. We've removed Bowser, but then later on we go back and insert Bowser in 1st, or at the 0th index as well. Let's try printing our results down below, and we'll see that Bowser appears now to be in 1st place, at the 0th index of our list. Now, one more thing we can do with lists, one more method to consider here, is one called reverse. In fact, I can call results.reverse if I wanted to flip the standings a little bit, turn whoever is in 8th into 1st, whoever's in 1st into 8th, and I could actually run this now and see the result. And we'll see our list has been reversed. We have Donkey Kong Jr. now in 1st, who was previously in last place, and Bowser, who was previously in 1st place, is now here in 1st. So these are a few methods to be familiar with as you go off and do work with lists. We've seen here append, we've seen extend, we've seen remove, and we've seen insert, and of course at the end here we've seen reverse. That's it for this short on lists. We'll see you next time.